state will be run by this same ethnic nationality,
The same way the state is being run by other people. We already have states. For instance, take Southern Kaduna. The people of Southern Kaduna, under the present Kaduna state, feel like an occupied people, an oppressed people, a marginalized people, an enslaved people, if I may use the word enslaved people.
How about the concerns that some states are already not viable?
Wait. When it comes to viability, apart from maybe Lagos, and maybe to some extent Ogun state, none of the present states is viable.
And then we create more.
That is what I'm telling you. So we all know that viability is not the criteria really for the existence of these states.
Right.
A lot of them were arbitrarily created by the military. So now we have created conditions whereby, number one, if we have made provision that mineral resources, if we all develop our mineral resources, each state can generate enough funds more or less to become viable.
You know, just
and we have made provision to enable states to develop their own mineral resources. We provided 5% of the funds going to the federal government are specifically devoted to the development of mineral resources within each state, so that each state can have, you know, other sources of revenue. We can all have other sources of revenue besides oil. Not only that, development of mineral resources is now concurrent. So as the federal government is developing mineral resources around the country, each state can also spend part of its own money to develop its own mineral resources. So that ultimately, there is an incentive for the states to develop their own mineral resources too. There can be so many other sources of revenue. We don't all have to sit on depending on oil money. Oil money is all we are spending now. Now, when I say with the exception of Lagos and Ogun, Lagos doesn't depend on oil money again. Lagos generates enough revenue from other sources that even if the oil money doesn't come, we can't survive.
But again, you know, they have their own complaint. And we had the former Attorney General of the state on our sister station, sister program, Sunrise Daily. He said, let me see if I can actually get that quote from him. We're talking about, Mr. Shukwu Shashare, Senior Advocate of Nigeria. He did say specifically, he said, quote, in an area like Lagos State, where over 90% of value-added tax is generated, and for Lagos State to receive 6 to 9% of its value-added tax generation, if that's not social injustice, it's just quite clear.
I wish you would sit across from me and say that.
Because he's a delegate from Lagos, yes. And you can imagine the complaint they also have, the reservation. Oh. If we say, well, resource control, and resource control is, according to his argument, is always mistaken to be something that has to do with oil or other resources we generate. But this is what is also generated by the state of Lagos.
The problem with Lagos State is that they were reluctant participants in this conference.
But they were there and they brought up this argument.
They were there as if they were not there.
How do you mean?
All the meetings that the Southwest had to promote the interests of the Southwest, Lagos, these people did not show up. They did not come. It was other people who were even promoting the interests of Lagos State. Left to these people that Fashola appointed, nobody will hear about Lagos there at all. These were people who virtually just came to Abuja on a sightseeing trip and did not actively participate in the conference. The Southwest always had the caucus meetings where issues affecting the Southwest states and so on were articulated and were promoted. They did not show up.
Let's talk
at
more
these meetings
about this.
So they have no point. And yet, other people promoted and actively promoted the interests of Lagos State. The issue which I'm sure you are talking about was nowhere to be seen. So they are talking to people like you in the media to show that they were at the conference.
Okay.
They were not at the conference. They just came physically. They just came sightseeing at the Abuja.
Senator Okoromo, that is
a
serious
allegation.
Yes, that's why I say I wish he was sitting in front of me.
Because, you know, they had their own points, their own agenda.
They were not active participants, quote me. They were not active participants at this conference. There were marginal participants who virtually came sightseeing. They did not participate along with South other Southwest delegates in promoting the interests of Southwest states.
Okay, that should be and for that, another day.
That affected the outcome generally.
Of course, other people promoted, other people defended the interests of Lagos, even without their participation.
Well, let's go back to the area of state creation.
Yes.
That
so they're coming to the area of state creation. I'll give the area of Southern Kaduna.
Kaduna.
There were, if you look at the so-called Southern Bauchi, Southern Borno, Southern Kebbi, there are lots of these states where there are ethnic minorities, Adamawa, and so on. If you look at the Adamawa state, so many minority groups there. Now, the minorities make up the majority in the Adamawa state. But if you are going to pick 10 people from Adamawa state, you hardly pick a minority. You end up picking the outside full anyone. People. So these people, again, they feel like enslaved people. They don't feel like equal citizens.
Creating
states for them, now they feel that they can be equal Nigerians. They can exercise the same rights and the same privileges, the same opportunities as other Nigerians.
You will
for them,
this
is what they have achieved.
There's
the issue of self-determination for ethnic minorities, which is recognized even by the UN, recognized all over the world. Even the Scottish people are asking for self-determination. Even from the United Kingdom, the Scottish people want their own independence.
Mr. Okun.
So self-determination is a universal cry worldwide now.
I agree with you.
That is what is causing the trouble in Eastern Ukraine. The people of Eastern Ukraine, they even want some kind of independence
Can
from
I come
the rest
in here?
Of Ukraine.
Can I come in here quickly? Creating states is one solution that you have made mention of.
Yes.
How about making the states that these people originally belong to, how about making the government of those states responsible for including them, other than separating them and creating new states for them?
For how long? The states have been in existence for a long time. They have refused to include them. They marginalized them.
Serious allegation. You're saying that the governments of those states have refused to include those people.
They don't even recognize them as equal citizens. That is the truth. That is the claim.
Just 1 minute.
That is the claim of these people, that they are not even recognized as equal citizens.
You made mention of, most of the states in Nigeria are not viable.
Yes.
And then we need to look for other ways of
raising revenue.
And you mentioned mineral resources.
Yes.
The new states that you have created, do they all have?
They all. There's no state in Nigeria that
you have just that
we
the
have,
new
we
states
them.
That
we,
you
all,
have
yes.
created.
In fact, we have a table.
They all have mineral resources.
Every part of this country has mineral resources, which if developed.
I'm saying those states.
They
that
do.
Created.
They do. They do. They do. They do.
I am not. My network does not react. We respond to issues. And we are not here to argue. We're trying to look at the outcome of the conference in itself. But one or two points I would like to clarify was one you just said, that the states were created not for viability. That, personally, I am against.
I said not on the basis of
viability. Uh-huh. It is not a thinking solution, with due respect. The other case of the LGs, which he said they had the LGs on the front burner. Now you're giving the state governor the go-ahead to create LGs. For God's sake, if the money to an LG is $10, I will create 100. If the money for LG, so that everybody will start looking for high numbers. That was why we were looking at the brass tacks. What is the basis of creation of an LG? You never addressed that. You were giving the man a free hand to keep on giving us LGs.
I think he has missed the point that I made.
Let me just finish
because basically I would like to go ahead from here, because the conference in itself, the outcome of the conference as we speak, is still not a legit material.
What do you mean by it is not a legitimate material?
Now, wait. For us to make the outcome of that confab legitimate takes two things. He said I will go to a referendum, which is not in our constitution, or we turn it back to the National Assembly. I said it in October 1st. The work of that confab is what the National Assembly is supposed to do. Now you are duplicating the work of the National Assembly, and you are telling the same National Assembly to rubber stamp what you are coming up with? You know what I'll say to you? Our constitution, it's barely a 200-page material.